В разгара на стачните протести в Гърция, бившият полски вицепремиер, финансов министър и управител на Централната банка на Полша Лешек Балцерович посети Атина и веднага прикова върху себе си медийното внимание. Всички очакват, че спечелилият си славата на баща на шоковата терапия полски икономист има рецепта за изход от гръцката икономическа криза. Преди година, като говорихте за глобалната икономическа криза, казахте, че решението се крие в производството, което дава възможност на икономиката да върне конкурентността си на световния пазар. Споделяте ли това мнение в случая на гръцката икономическа криза?
Supply response is very important, that policies should not hurt private investment, that policies should create confidence and not create too much risks. And if, generally speaking, policies will be on such a nature in the major economies of the world, then the crisis will be over. It is over in the sense that there are no deeper and deeper recession. The question is now, what will be economic growth? And economic growth will differ depending on the policies regarding the supply side. With respect to Greece, as it well known, in Greece there has been two problems. The one, a huge fiscal deficit and accumulating public debt to GDP ratio. And the second problem was supply side, meaning that there was too much spending in Greece at the cost of increasing debt, including private debt, that competitiveness has suffered. So Greece has to restore through reforms both fiscal soundness and competitiveness.
Условията на високи данъци, лошо трудово законодателство и нулево кредитиране, реалната икономика на Гърция умира бавно. Какво може да се направи, за да се окуражи местното производство?
I can only judge by what I've read. And I just read the recent IMF report. It does not say that the Greek economy is dying. It says that there is a decline in GDP. Yes, it had to be expected. There was much deeper decline in the Baltics, but they are coping. And the key point is that problems which have contributed to the crisis should be removed through reforms. And I try to mention these most important reforms. Let me repeat, on the fiscal side, reforms which would reduce spending, and say pension reforms is a very important reform because it helps to reduce spending. On the supply side, eliminating monopolies, eliminating restrictions of the free entry, like what has been done with the truck drivers, and generally speaking, introducing competition. Market economy without competition cannot work very well.
Лешек Балцерович е много предпазлив, когато говори за банковата система в Гърция.
Well, I can't be very specific on the banks because I have not studied their problems. I can only say that IMF report stresses that, generally speaking, there is pretty high capital ratio in the banks, so they don't see any alarming problems. But certain banks are very important, so measures to improve their capital ratios belong to important reforms.
Mergers.
Whether mergers help or not, one has to study them. I am not in a position to comment on specific mergers.
А какъв съвет би дал на гръцкото правителство?
The Greek government has been introducing reforms despite protests, which seem to me declining over time rather than increasing. And I think this is the right approach because every responsible decision maker should compare two situations. The one, what would happen without reforms? Then economic situation would only get worse and everybody would protest. And the second scenario is, let us go for reforms. There will be some protests. Let us persist. And if we persist with the right reforms, then economy would recover and there would be less protests and better future.
Колко време ще отнеме това?
Take what?
To reforms, to bring fruits, to bring...
Well, there are analogies. If you stabilize fast, like we did in Poland, to some extent in Bulgaria. Then more inflationary pressures can be eliminated pretty fast. This is not the case of Greece, because in Greece they don't have very high inflation. They have rather removed rigidities of the markets. But usually it is not years before benefits of reform start. It takes months, and then if you persist, if you improve the economy large sufficiently, then systematically it is going to improve. Let me say that we in Poland and Bulgaria have been facing much more serious problems, because we inherited very high inflation, we inherited declining economy, which was paralyzed by various regulations, and we have managed. So why not Greece?
А какво ще се случи с гръцкия дълг? Ще има ли разсрочване на плащанията? Ще има ли опрощаване на част от дълга? И в крайна сметка, кой ще плати за него? Гражданите на Европейския съюз или гражданите на Гърция?
This is a tricky question, so I don't want to make any firm declaration. I don't have enough information anyway. I can only say that I recently have read a very good paper written by IMF economist, which stresses that with reforms, Greek can cope without debt reduction.
По отношение на връщането към драхмата, професор Бълцерович е категоричен.
I don't think so. It is utterly unrealistic, first politically, because I don't think there are any political forces in Greece, serious political forces in Greece, which would go for that. Second, economically, because there would be huge problems. Much debt is denominated in euro. So with devaluation through the reintroduction of drachma, there would be a shock, because debt in nominal terms would be much higher. So I don't think this is a realistic and good option. Rather, the Greeks should look to the Baltics or to Bulgaria. You have maintained a link to euro, so you did not devalue. But you try to regain competitiveness through what is called internal devaluation, reducing wages or reducing the wage growth, improving productivity. So this is the right approach.
Полският економист не вижда в гръцката криза заплаха за еврозоната.
I don't think so. That catastrophic scenario have to be fulfilled. I think that the problems with Greece has alarmed the eurozone countries to the problems which existed before, but they were not coped with. And now there is with disincentives, both at the country levels and the European levels, there are new initiatives. At the country levels, look at Spain. Spain's socialist became Thatcherite. They are slashing spending. They are reforming the labor market in order to avoid Greek problems, to regain confidence of the markets. To some extent, the same goes on in Portugal, Ireland. So there are initiatives, the level of respective member countries of the Eurozone. At the European level, there is much discussion how to strengthen fiscal discipline, how to make stability and growth pact effective. And I think this method, this is important.